All right, mic check, 1, 2, 3, mic check, 1, 2, 3, take one. How to make a cinematic video with this budget 85mm lens, take one, action. Hi, my name is Justin. I'm a photographer, YouTube filmmaker, and a full-time dad. I was out one afternoon with my family in one of the busiest shopping streets here in Vienna, and we just happened to chance upon a group of very talented musicians performing on the street. I didn't have any other lens with me that day, and I sure as hell didn't bring a gimbal, but I knew I had to be able to capture the passion that I was feeling from their performance. The only idea I had was that I needed to capture the musicians, their instruments, and their movements as best as I could. This is the Viltrox 85mm f1.8 Mark I lens, and I've had this for 2 years already, and I use it mainly for street photography and portraiture. It's sharp, it's got very good autofocus, and the compression that you get from a telephoto lens like this and that f1.8 aperture really makes for some beautiful photos and creamy bokeh. I honestly think that this is one of the best, if not the best, value lens that you can get for your Sony full-frame cameras. However, I haven't used this much for video work because it doesn't have image stabilization, which means that shooting with it, especially at a focal length like 85mm, means that the image that you can get with it, even with the smallest and slightest of movements, can be very shaky. So I set my camera to shoot at 120 frames per second and set my shutter speed to 1 over 250th of a second to make sure that I was following the 180 degree rule. And I did that for two main reasons. The first being because I knew I was going to be editing this on a 24 frames per second timeline to achieve a cinematic look. I knew that using a video shot at a higher shutter speed, such as 1 over 250th of a second, will make my videos look jagged, jarring, and maybe even exaggerate the movements a little bit more, which was kind of the look that I wanted to have for my video. And the next one being because I knew that if I wanted to later in post, I could slow it down for some really smooth slow motion footages, which I did end up doing eventually. For most of the shots, I was at a stationary position, keeping in mind the limitations of shooting at such a long focal length. So I did my best to do some very slow panning, very basic swivels, and held the camera as steady as I could. I took a couple of creative shots by slowly turning the camera whilst following the movement, trying to capture every swish and flick of the musicians because I wanted to be able to create an even more intense feeling. Now take all of that and partner it with the compression and the wide aperture that you get with a Viltrox 85mm f1.8, and you'll get something like this. I will say that one of the good things I really liked about shooting with this lens that day, despite the apparent trickiness of shooting at such a long focal length handheld, was that I was able to do so at a bit of a distance from them, which meant I wasn't blocking anyone else's view, and more importantly, I wasn't distracting the musicians themselves. So there you have it. I hope you learned something here today. This is just a short video, and I wanted to share a few tips in order for you to be able to shoot kind of a similar cinematic video with the Viltrox 85mm f1.8 lens. My name is Justin, and if you like this video, please don't forget to hit that like button. Consider subscribing if you haven't already, and as always, thanks for watching.